In this session, we will discuss about activity life cycle for different events or for different scenarios. This can also be important interview question. Many times interviewer may give you different scenario and he may ask you draw activity life cycle for this scenario. For example, when user rotates phone, what is the life cycle flow or etc. So let me mark this also. Important interview question. Before understanding activity life cycle flow for different scenarios, first let me cover very briefly about each method. For my explanation convenience, I have given numbers for each method. OnCreate method will be called once Android operating system creates object for your activity. So OnCreate method will be called once memory is allocated for your screen, in simple terms. OnStart method will be called just before showing your screen to user on the mobile phone. That means just before showing your screen to user on the mobile phone, operating system will call OnStart method. OnResume method will be called once your screen is visible to user and your screen is on top of all other screens. That means OnStart will be called just before showing your screen to user, and once your screen is visible to user or shown to user, Android system will call OnResume. Once OnResume is called, that means your screen is on top of all other screens. That means your screen is the topmost screen and user is looking at your screen at this point of time. That's why after OnResume is being called, your activity is said to be either in the resumed state or foreground state. Here I have highlighted this. Foreground means it is on top of all other screens. Resumed means currently user is interacting with your screen. That is the meaning. OnPause will be called as the first indication that user is moving away from your screen for whatever the reason it may be. When user is moving away from your screen, as the first indication, Android system will call OnPause method. For example, when user presses back button, user is moving away from your screen to previous screen. So there are many other scenarios which we will discuss later. OnStop method will be called once your screen is completely invisible to user. For example, when user presses home button or back button, your screen will be completely invisible and control will go to another screen. In such kind of cases, OnStop method will be called. Remember always, OnStop method will be called only after OnPause. OnDestroy method will be called by operating system just before killing your screen and just before removing your screen from memory. Don't get confused between OnStop and OnDestroy. OnStop means your screen is invisible. OnDestroy means your screen is completely killed. OnRestart method will be called when user is returning back to your screen, maybe from a new screen. This is very brief information about each method. Now let us see different scenarios. First scenario is when user starts your screen, what is the life cycle method flow? Tell me how user can start your screen. User can go to home screen and there will be lot of launcher icons. When user clicks corresponding launcher icon which is suitable for your screen, on clicking that launcher icon, Android system will automatically open your activity. For example, let us say you have designed one nice messaging application which looks like this on the right hand side, and assume that main activity is the first screen of your messaging application which displays welcome to messaging application. In order to open that application, I have taken home screen on the left hand side where you can observe messaging icon, launcher icon. When user clicks on this messaging icon, Android system will internally open our first screen of messaging application. Now consider this scenario. Now let us see, when user clicks on this messaging icon, what is the life cycle flow? Let us say this is a Java file of your main activity, public class main activity, extends app compat activity. We know that by default onCreate lifecycle method will be there in your activity Java file. Just like onCreate method, let us say just below onCreate method, there are two more lifecycle methods, onStart and onResume. Like this, though order doesn't matter, as a good programmer, you should practice this order. As of now, don't worry what is the code to be written inside onStart and onResume. Just imagine that programmer has written these three lifecycle methods in the main activity Java file. Now, when user clicks this launcher icon, first control will be given to Android operating system, and Android operating system will internally give control to Dalvik virtual machine, which will create an object for main activity. Remember, before displaying an activity on the screen, first object should be created for that class in the RAM memory. Here I have represented same thing in the pictorial representation. When user clicks on messaging icon, step 1, control will be given to Android operating system, and Android operating system will dispatch control to Dalvik virtual machine, because all Android applications will be under control of DVM, Dalvik virtual machine. From now onwards, whenever I say Android operating system or DVM, assume that both are same only. Though both are different, sometimes I may call DVM as Android system. Now internally, DVM will create an object for your main activity, because before displaying your main activity on the phone, first that object should be created. Once object is being created, the control will enter into onCreate method saying, observe carefully the first point, onCreate method will be called once object is created for your activity in the memory. So same thing is happening here. So once control enters here, that means object is already created for your screen. After executing all these lines, next step is, after onCreate method, always control goes to onStart method if it is available. Remember, if programmer has written onStart method, then only control will enter into onStart method. Otherwise, it will search for next lifecycle method. Let us say programmer has written onStart and onResume methods. So step 3, after executing onCreate method logic, control will automatically enter into onStart method before displaying your screen to user. Once control enters into onStart method, it is Android system is indicating that I am about to show your screen to user on the phone. Once this method is completely executed, immediately Android system will display your screen to user on the mobile phone. That is step 4. That means after onStart method, currently user is looking at your screen. Once the screen is visible to user, now control will internally come to onResume method. onResume method will be called, indicating that now your screen is visible to user. Now your screen is on the top of all other screens. That's why after onResume method, your activity is said to be in the foreground state, or resumed state, or running state. This is a life cycle flow of your activity when user launches your screen. So first onCreate method will be executed, then onStart. After onStart, your screen is visible to user. After that, onResume will be called. Once onResume will be called, don't think that immediately it will go to onPause. Though here I am mentioning onPause will come after onResume only in few cases. Here the control will stop here. Now user is interacting with your screens. I hope you understood first scenario.